हेलो एवरीवन, दिस इज़ दीप्ति परमार। आई रन अ स्मॉल डिजिटल एजेंसी कॉल 99 स्टेयर्स। थैंक्स टू मैट्स फॉर हैविंग मी हियर। इट इज़ रियली अ ग्रेट प्लेजर टू बी एन इलस्ट्रियस कंपनी ऑफ द गाइज लाइक क्रैग कैम्बेल एंड बीबी द लिंक बिल्डर एंड ऑफकोर्स अदर्स। So as I said, I run a small digital agency, but I have huge clients. Why? Because of the quality content I create for them. So in today's presentation, I am going to share some of my secrets that how you can using them, how you too can be a content marketing powerhouse. So let's get on with it, and please bear with my Indian accent. How to be a content marketing powerhouse. So before I start my presentation, or before I tell you what I am, what's more important is what I have done, why I am capable to tell you about why you should go for content marketing. So let me make some assumptions about you, as I can't see any of you. So I think you can be a marketer or an entrepreneur or a startup founder, or you may have your small or medium sized startup agency. You can be a blogger or a content marketer. Then this content based growth strategy is really for you. So these are some of the brands I have helped. Adobe is the fifth largest software company in the world. Who doesn't know this brand? And then Buffer is again a very popular social media scheduling tool. Nutanix, Semrush is one of the most popular digital marketing tool suit, and Nutanix is again in the list of Forbes biggest software companies. This is a snapshot from their Semrush internal presentation, which they might be giving to their stakeholders or clients. Now they are proud of the work I do for them. This is one quote from me, which is published in CIO. So why, how I am doing this? Here is another example from Nutanix. Nutanix is it was the finalist for the best B2B market branded content campaign award, which was held in 2020. This is Ken Kalpan, who is the editor-in-chief for them, and he has credited me here as one of the key contributor who made it possible for them, or who is having some part in that success. My article which I wrote for them is one of the top 5 article of their ranking, one of the top 5 out of their 10 ranking pages in Google. These two are very popular bloggers from India, Shout Me Loud and iGeeks blog. They are really doing very good work in that field. They probably have 2,000 million visitors per month. They are publishing tons of content. They know probably everything about digital marketing. They want to work with me. Why? Because probably they still have much further to go where they think I can help them. So yes, as this is one of the standalone interview I was able to publish for Harsh Agrawal, and you can see this is my author bio. So he is, as I said, he is already a guy who is doing tremendous job, but still there is some way for him to go, and I was able to place some part in his truckload of achievement. So as through this presentation, I want to answer, I will attempt to answer these two burning questions of content marketing. If you are a marketer or a blogger or a consultant, you must be wondering how you can work with the best brands in your niche. Whereas if you are a owner, then you must be thinking how you can make exponential growth. So here my answer is by building your authority and providing your expertise. How you can do this? You have to figure out where our marketing heads, CEOs, CMOs or CTOs are reading. What are they are reading? Where you can find them? Which platforms will influence them? You just get on those platforms and probably you have win the half battle. But how you will do this? Probably by creating the right content. Not probably, that is the only way to do it in today's scenario. Content is the center of all digital marketing. And for me, this is blogging is the best way to do this, because when you are blogging, when you are promoting your content through this PPC or social media or other channel, they are fleeting. You can get the results till the time you invest something in that. You invest your time or you invest your money. Whereas blogging is this thing which is of course a long game, but it will also give you results for the longer period of time. So, and once you publish your blog, you can publish it through your various things like organic, PPC, social media, email, or whatever is your strength. Now, I am contributor at all of these places. I have built my authority by publishing my thoughts on all these popular platforms. So, as I have proved my authority, let me tell something about me. My clients call me Content Queen of India, and I started working in this industry before 12 years, and I just started by my own before 3 years ago, and then I started one of my fashion blog. I really like it so much, and that is my passion actually. That is one of my passion. It is a woman fashion and lifestyle blog. Then almost a year and a half ago, I started my own agency, Digital 99 Stats, with my very good friend Rohan Iyer, who was earlier working with Semrush. So here, these are the things my team do. Content marketing, SEO, and personal branding are the things we are handling, and content marketing is, of course, my forte. So, what is the success of content marketing? We all do all this works because we want best clients, right? So we wait for best clients, or we run after best clients, and then we think we provide expertise and we build authority for them, and then we will create great content for that. This is the usual scenario, but there is some problem with this. This is actually inverted. There are never so many clients. विथ कॉन्टेंट मार्केटिंग और वॉट आई एम गोइंग टू टीच यू टूडे इज यू हैव टू फर्स्ट क्रिएट अ लार्ज बेस ऑफ ग्रेट कॉन्टेंट एंड देन बेस्ड ऑन दैट यू कैन बिल्ड योर अथॉरिटी एंड यू कैन प्रूव योर एक्सपर्टीज एंड देन ओनली यू कैन गेट बेस्ट क्लाइंट्स बिकॉज वैन यू आर वाई बेस्ट क्लाइंट शुड हायर यू हाउ दे विल बी एबल टू जज यू यू आर डूइंग गुड यू विल बी एबल टू डू गुड वर्क फॉर दैम वैन द ब्रांड्स वी हैव टॉक्ड अर्लियर फॉर whom I have worked, how they are such a big names that they can hire anybody. Then why should they hire me? So first of all, I have to build my authority. Same way, you have to create great content and you have to invest your time in that, and then only you will be able to gain your that strength that you can go to your clients and say, yes, this is what I have done and this is the great work I can do for you. So here I humbly submit that there is one thing I want to drive you home is create quality content. Now when there is one dilemma, content creation and distribution dilemma. Now everybody wants to save their great content for the biggest platforms, right? To like, if you are guest posting, you will think that you will publish your best piece on Inc or Entrepreneur or some very popular website. But why this websites will take you as a contributor? For that you have to, those all editors of these websites are really great in their work, so of course they will want to see why they should invest their time in reading your content. So for that you have to show some examples of your work. So yes, you will think that there is always, whenever you are starting content marketing, there is always, it's like you are caught between devil and the deep sea situation, whether you should invest your money or you should create great content for other platforms, or what if that you are not getting enough eyeballs for your content, then the money you have spent on quality content is totally wasted. But trust me, take my words on this, that just go for the only quality thing. If you are not going to create quality content, it is never going to be useful in any case. So why should we go for average thing? If you are showing this average thing to this top sites, they are not going to like it. So only option you have left is creating quality content. So that is where our next slide goes, create top quality content. Now, as I said, you must be wondering how you can create quality content. Like if you are a blogger, you may have your own blog. Then you will think, my blog doesn't have so many visitors. Then what I will do by publishing on my blog? But as I said, this content marketing thing is really a long game, and for that you have to start somewhere. Like if you don't have example to show to the big websites, they won't allow you to go there. So at somewhere you have to start. So these are the places you can start building your thought leadership. If you are a blogger, then of course your own blog is the best place, because that is your own blog. It will be there forever for you. After 5 years, 10 years, they are not going to go anywhere. If you are a marketer or working in any agency, probably your own agency's blog is the best place for you to put your thoughts on I myself also started that way only before 6 years when I was working with marketing agency, and I started contributing from my own my company's on my company's website blog. When if you are an entrepreneur and small business owner, then of course your company's blog is the best place for you. And if you are a consultant or C-suite executives, there are so many popular blogs in the industry. Your industry specific blog is the place for you, like CIO Inc. or CMO.coms are the all C-suite blogs. You can start from there. As I have already convinced you that quality content are the only way for you to go forward, we have also gone through that the places where you should blog about or where you should publish your thoughts. Now the next most important question is, what will you blog about? What would be the topics you will be writing? So this is probably a perennial problem, and it is the oldest problem in the content marketing industry. For this, I will drive you through this three-step process. It is context, intent, and relevance. To create any masterpiece, you have to understand the what is context now. You first have to understand what is the situation of your reader. Why would someone want to consume your content? Why will they read your content? The second thing is intent. What do they want to do with this content? How can this content help them accomplish their goal? How it can be useful to them? And the last step is relevance. Relevance is the best match of your content at that particular time. Why at that particular time your content is, why they will read your content at that time? They must be in some situation and they want to consume or read your content at that particular time only. Let's say you are a fitness blogger, right? And before a year at this time, probably when COVID started, everybody was at home. At that time, you could have write about the exercises you want to, you can do at your home, in your balcony or in the on your terrace. So your user might be different. Some of them might be beginner, some of them might be already fitness freak and going gym every day, but their situation at that point is they are stuck at home, so they must be looking for some advanced level exercises which they can perform at home. So you can blog about advanced level fitness exercises which you can perform at home. And so in their situation is they are stuck at home. So when you are publishing that this content, they might be relevant for them at that particular time, at the time of COVID when they are stuck. So now after a year when lockdown is lifted, probably you can write something about and people have started going out, you can write something about precaution they can take when they are going outside for exercise, probably if they are going to a garden, things they can carry at garden. So this is the relevant time. It doesn't mean that you shouldn't blog work from home exercises earlier, but probably this is a time when you can blog about and you can get more eyeball for your piece. Like before COVID, everybody was that वर्क फ्रॉम होम कल्चर वॉज नॉट दैट पॉपुलर एट एवरीवेयर. मोस्ट ऑफ द पीपल यूज टू प्रेफर वर्क फ्रॉम ऑफिस, बट नाउ इज़ द टाइम वैन एवरीबडी हैज़ स्टार्टेड इम्प्लीमेंटिंग दिस वर्क फ्रॉम होम स्ट्रेटजीज. So CEOs of different companies or HR of different companies might be searching best to work from home strategies, and then you are probably a person who is selling some who is providing such remote office setup service, or you can be a VPN software. So this is the right time for you to blog about that. This is the time when you can expect that maximum people would consume your content, and you will get maximum output from your from what you are writing or what you are publishing. So to create any masterpiece, you need to understand this whole thing. When you get it right, then trust me, the content you will come up with will really, really be very useful and a great piece. Here we can't, we intent, according to me, intent is the most important thing. Of course, all are interlinked, but we will start with intent research. Trust me, we cannot ignore the importance of intent. Intent, usually before anybody start creating content, whoever is familiar with SEO best practices will start with keyword research. But let me give you a quote from my best friend and my business partner Rohan. He said, intent it's keywords for breakfast. And he was the first person in the industry to advocate the use of intent research over keyword research. If you search intent research in Google, and his article on search engine watch is ranking on the first position, you just go and read it and you will get to know everything about intent research. So intent is the place from where keyword emerge. So you should start, we should go after intent research, because Google is also becoming smart. It is no more just a search engine. Google has become an answer engine nowadays. Whenever you are searching, whenever you start searching something, it will start showing you answers. When you will search for some particular query, when you again search something related to that previous query, it will show you the result automatically. Like if you will search for Joe Biden, and then when you will search age, it will give you the age of Joe Biden. So here you need to understand intent to start with your keyword. So let me be more clear by this example. Let's see, someone is searching for tomato plants. Now that person can be anyone. They can be farmer, that person can be student or a person who is doing research on tomato plants, or there can be some random person who is pursuing their hobby. So probably today they are not exactly looking for just their intent can be something different. They are probably looking for some seeds, or they are looking for they have already planted their tomatoes, and they can be looking for some pesticides to spray on. So how it goes, like once somebody is searching for tomato plants, tomorrow they will search for when to plant those tomatoes, probably they are planning in their mind that once they will get enough information about tomato plants, and then they will go to the next step. So they will search for best season to plant tomatoes, or best tricks or tips to plant tomatoes. Then tomorrow they will search once their plants are grown up, they will search for how to care for those tomatoes. Once they are more grown up and they are turning yellow, they will be searching for some pesticides to take care of that. Then they can search for best season to or best place to sell those tomatoes. So being a client, or being while you are creating content, you need to understand where your user stands, what they are actually looking for. In fact, you can suggest them what they can do next. So here you need to understand their whole intent, and that intent can take you towards the goal of the customer. So for that you need to find keywords around the intent of your customer. When your customers are looking for best season to plant tomato, what will be the words they will be using for to search that particular term? So here we will use, of course, keyword research tool, because there are no such tools as who call themselves intent research tool yet. So we will be, of course, using this keyword research tool. But make sure intent of your customer is the source of your keyword research. And now this keyword research is itself a very huge topic, so to cover it in depth, we will need another presentation for that. So I won't go that deep into that, but there are zillions of tools available, AHREF, Keyword Explorer, and Semrush Topic Research are two of my favorite tools. Once you prepare a list of topics from your intent, you can probably go through these tools and search for your keywords. They provide you plenty of information, it will give you titles or questions around your topics. So once you are done with this, what comes next is map content to the funnel. This is the marketing funnel. Once if you are in marketing or sales, or you must be aware of this funnel. So once you have decided the topics you want to write on, once you know the intent of your customer and size of your audience, or how close they are to buying your product, then I just want to tell you what you have to do next is to map the content you want to create. It could be anything, blog post or quizzes or ebooks for download, or even a demo for your customer. So that how we will do. See, recently a good friend of mine came to me and asked, I want to create a B2B marketing blog. Now I know this guy very well. He is in sales, and he is very good at lead generation. So I asked him, why you want to you are good you are very good at lead generation, why you want to write overall about B2B marketing? So his concern was that if he will only write about lead generation, he won't get that much awareness, and in short period of time he will run out of ideas. So yes, what he thought is right. So what आई टोल्ड हिम वॉट ही कैन डू इन हीज केस और वॉट वी कैन डू इज़ वी कैन पब्लिश मोर जनरल लेवल आइडियाज़ और मोर टॉप लेवल आइडियाज़ ऑन एग्जिस्टिंग प्लेटफॉर्म. इन हीज केस ही कैन प्रोबेबली गो आई सजेस्टेड हिम टू गो एंड बी अ कंट्रीब्यूटर ऑन दी साइट्स लाइक हबस्पॉट और मार्केटो और शॉपिफाई हु ऑलरेडी हैज़ वेरी गुड अथॉरिटी एंड वेरी गुड व्यूअरशिप. इट विल हेल्प हिम टू जनरेट मोर अवेयरनेस अबाउट अबाउट he's thought leader, his ideas. So yes, so here these are the three things. Awareness are more for like posting content on other blogs, social media, infographic or other primary level searches comes in this awareness funnel. And once your user are know enough about you, and when they have something related to you, like he can blog about this overall B2B marketing stuff, and when somebody is looking for lead generation solutions, they can come to his website. That is this middle level of content where he can have this educational resources, he can write about quizzes, he can offer discounts, he can hold his webinars, and in through that he can bring them to this last level where he can give demos and share his customer stories and webinars. So top level content are more for awareness, and the medial level and the this bottom level content are for more of your money making pages. So yes, once you get your intent right, once you know where do your users stand, once you will get this right, I am sure you have win the half of the battle. Now once probably this guy won't be that much expert in everything about B2B marketing. Or even though you are an expert, it is not possible for you to write everything, because of course if you will do that, then when you will do your job in which you are actually an expert. So now as you have decided that you will be write great content and you will be building your thought leadership through content, you will be publishing blog post on you may start your own blog, and you will also publish quality content or content which generate more awareness for your business on the this top publications. The most important question which comes next is finding writers. So a dose of reality for you is you are not a writer. You probably know you can't write well. It follows that you can't evaluate well either. So let me but of course we want to build your authority, so you have to start from somewhere. And in that case, you will need somebody who can put your thoughts in better words. And probably finding good writer can simplify this job for you. So here is like Fiverr, Upwork, content marketplaces and job sites. Please don't look there or you will be disappointed. Only you won't be getting good writers from there. I guess Fiverr and Upwork, everybody is aware from those sites. Content marketplaces, let me show you. This is one example from Text Broker, who is a content marketplace. Now if you will see, they are providing four types of content.
फर्स्ट वन इज कुड कंटेन स्पेलिंग ग्रामेटिकल एंड पंक्चुएशन मिस्टेक्स. नाउ व्हेन इट कंटेंट स्पेलिंग और ग्रामेटिकल मिस्टेक्स व्हाई यू वांट टू राइट दैट यू वांट टू बिल्ड योर अथॉरिटी नॉट यू वांट टू डाउनग्रेड योर इम्प्रेशन इन फ्रंट ऑफ अदर्स. अगेन द नेक्स्ट लेवल इज क्विक ऑर्डर प्रोसेसिंग एंड एवरेज क्वालिटी राइटिंग. ट्रस्ट मी इफ यू आर गोइंग फॉर एवरेज क्वालिटी देन प्लीज डोंट गो फॉर इट एट ऑल. डोंट इवन ट्राई इफ यू आर गोइंग फॉर एवरेज. इट इज नॉट गोइंग टू बी हेल्पफुल. प्रोबेबली यू विल यू करंटली राइटर्स माइट बी चार्जिंग $200 or $250 and you think you can get it returns from somewhere in $20-$30, but if that piece is not accepted by any quality site, or then that money are totally wasted. So rather than going for this average thing, it is better that you don't go for at all, because you will spend $100 on 2-3 pieces and still you won't get desired result. It will disappoint you more. So let's come back here. So third one is very good quality, most popular quality content, that's fine. And the fourth one is professional quality writing ready for use. Then how about the third one? They are not professional quality writing, and if they are not professional quality writing, then why would you need it at all? So yes, this content marketplaces doesn't work for me. So now let me, so what are the other places you can look? LinkedIn, it is really a best way to get it is of course social networking, professional networking site. So you will find if you are posting your requirement over there, you can expect that you will get good writers from there. Facebook private groups are again here, see, I have posted in one woman in content marketing private groups. These are really very good groups because they are well maintained by the administrators. Here you can see I have given information about myself, what I am doing, then examples, the kind of work I am doing. I am currently doing and I am looking for, so they will have, and here you I have given what kind of work I am looking for, so it explains a lot. Here you can see I have received so many comments, and more than comments, I received so many private messages, so it helped me to get at least 3 writers through this one message, because this group is really very popular group, and all the women in content marketing from the world is mostly part of this group. And of course you can get recommendations from other. Here is a forum, Pro Blogger. They are really good. This is from where you can you can expect you will get professional quality writing. Blogging Pro is, I guess, one another search forum blog. Here you will get writers in whatever niche you are looking for, fashion or SaaS products. They really have good writers who have understanding that what they should write and what is called quality writing. So yes, other than that, let's get back to finding writers. Like, yes, so yes, LinkedIn, as I said, it is a really very good place. Facebook groups, I have already showed you one example. Twitter is again a very good place, and I think nowadays everybody is using that, though. So you are getting fast response from there. Real world is always better. You can meet your candidate, and then you can the one-to-one interaction is of course beneficial in all way. You can make them understand in better way what are your requirements, and you can probably they listen what difficulties they are facing, and you can probably work out something. So real world is of course best. Specialized job boards, which I shared, Blogging Pro and Pro Blogger, are two of them are really good. And outsourcing to an agency like me. So let's back to our presentation. So what was next? Working with writers. Now once you have already find writer, right, what your job would be? Writers are of course good at research, but you are the thought leader. You want to be thought leader. That is, you are the expert of the topic you are creating. So here your job won't be like just provide a topic to the writer and just ask them like, I need 1,000-word topic, the 1,000-word post on this topic. When you will need quality piece, you have to put your thoughts, like you have to, you should come up with title of your post. You can come up with alternatives, like it doesn't need to be very good, but of course it should be, it should explain what exactly you are looking for. Structure the post and create subsections, as I said. If you are writing B2B lead generation strategies, then you are the person who is generating leads. So you must be exactly knowing what would be the topics or what would be the best points for that. And you can find reference links for the writers to steal from. Not steal from, of course, but yes, when you will give them references, it will make the picture more clear for them. And of course, before it goes live, or if before you are sending that to any editor, please proofread your piece. Because as I know, that picture you have to draw. Writers are the person who will feel colors in your picture, but that structure or picture is clear in your mind. That is not clear in writer's mind. Your role is to make it that clear that writer can feel beautiful colors in that, and ultimately it turns out a tremendous piece. So that is your job. Now what would be writer's job? Writer's job, you have to look out that these are the things you have to make sure, because you are giving your content to the writer. So you make sure they do in-depth research for you, offer you unique perspectives and insights. They don't need to copy from from the reference links you have given, but you have to, they have to search for more, they have to do research on those topics more. No fluffing doesn't work. Like nowadays SEO is so popular, I guess everybody knows that, right? Digital marketing is the thing. So we don't need to increase our word count, because that is not gonna work in the long run. Provide
test statistics, visuals and examples wherever applicable in your article. Now statistics really help in effectively presents the results. It helps you prove your point that whatever you are saying is best for your user at that particular time, and it is proven method. Like I am writing a post on mobile SEO or mobile website design, I can give statistics like this many users are going to consume your content, or this is the ratio of your users who are going to watch your website on mobile. So that's why it is very much necessary for you to go for mobile website or mobile SEO. Visuals, a picture is worth a thousand words. So of course visuals and examples are will make a great piece. Write, the next point is write an introduction with a hook. Don't stretch the introduction. You can introduce your topic and then come to the main point. Takeaway in each section will really help, and an actionable conclusion will complete your entire topic. So being a thought leader, it is your job to make sure that writers have maintained the highest standards and followed guidelines, because ultimately it is your reputation on the line. So now you know how to create a best piece. The next step will be how to reach out to the best publications, because of course your goal is to make your content visible everywhere. So here, why do you need outreach? So whenever you are in content marketing, outreach can be done for the like thought leadership via blog post, which we are talking in this session. Digital PR of your company, this can be sponsored. Product reviews, there are so many bloggers and influencers out there in the market who can probably review your product and write detailed reviews for your product. So those reviews really help you in ranking, as well as it will help users to select right product for themselves. Outreaching is really helpful in link building and brand mentions as well. I frequently mention different tools in my post whenever writing, which are really useful. So probably those companies can come to me and ask me, you have already mentioned this tool in your post, so can you please link it to my website, so I can get some benefit from there. So this is how link building can be done. Or you can ask for brand mentions via outreaching. Then resource promotion, like if you have published any study, infographics or white papers, you can reach out and ask different bloggers or person to talk about your study in their post. So but we will stick to thought leadership via blog post in this session. So now, how you will select publications, what you will do, how you will get to know what are the good blogs for you to do guest posting. And so this is something like here, write for us page, the blogs which are accepting guest post. You can search for like terms like write for us, become a contributor, contributor guidelines. Such there is a list of such keywords which you can use, but for that it is not always necessary. Whoever is having write for us page will be a good blog. They all are not good blogs.
So like this is some once you will go through that write for us page, you will get that feel that whether this is the right blog for you or not. Because whoever is serious about blogging or whoever is accepting quality content for that blog must spend time on creating a very good write for us page. This website doesn't look good to me. They claim themselves the ninja team. This is by reading this, I just get the feeling this is not something where I would like my content, where I would like to see my content. Then again you can just go through different posts, this post, this this you can see the UX of that particular blog. This is a B2B blog, but they are I think publishing everything like website design, website development, why the Americans kick butt when it comes to new product marketing. So they are not particularly B2B marketing blogs. They are publishing everything. So now you have to decide that where you want to go. You want to build, you want to select one particular niche, or you want to go to the broad niche. Here, this is not something I would like to see. So here are a few things which you can check while selecting a perfect blog for you to guest post, like quality of the post. Once you will see, as you know, as you are the thought leader, you must be knowing what type of content you are publishing, right? So you should go through some of the posts written on those blogs. You see the quality, how are the other posts. I have seen still in this period of time, people are talking about clocking and doorway pages. Trust me, there are some sites who are still publishing this type of content. So that is not the place for you to go forward. Now the another method is checking web traffic, web metrics like traffic, domain authority, which is provided. I use most for the domain authority. You can use SEMrush or similar web for to check the traffic, what is the traffic or that particular website on which you are going to blog. Let's say the website is having 50,000 traffic per month. You can expect some visitor from there on your website. What are the next is what are the engagement metrics, social shares, and how many comments are that, how much are different social shares on their websites. Then today everybody is starting their own blog in the impression that through affiliate marketing they will make so much money. So they will put they just put ads anywhere on the website. So once you will check, you will have that you will see that ad shouldn't be intrusive or they are not disturbing. And then you can see profiles of existing contributors. Of course, you know all the thought leaders in your industry or the popular persons whom you are following. So this you can probably go and check out where they are posting their content, and you can reach out those sites. You can see frequency of the post on that particular blog. Let's say there are certain blogs like they publish monthly one blog monthly. So when you are I don't say that they are not publishing frequently, so they are not good bloggers or they don't run good blog. But when you are starting out initially, it is usually takes you reach out to that particular publication, you get reply in day two or in a week period of time, and then you work on the that post. And so this whole process takes a month at least. For me, it takes around a month to post, to go the post live. So if initially you are selecting that kind of site which is publishing only one post per month, then it is going to take so much time for your post to go live. So so of course this type, you can short out this type of blogs, and do, if they are really good blogs, you can do post later on. So this, now how you will reach out them, what are the best ways to approach? First, please read and follow the contributor guidelines on most of the blogs, or whoever is having this Write For Us page or provided contributor clear contributor contribution guidelines. You must read them from top to bottom, because trust me, this all editors are so busy person. If you are not following their guidelines, they won't care to read your content. They won't care to read your email even. So they have put so much effort in creating the that page itself. So give respect to that and read it carefully. Like every blog have their own things. Like some writer, some bloggers will ask post through Google Drive. So in that case, if you have not read those guidelines, you are losing a chance there. Second thing is, you can contact them through their contact form on the website. And these are some common methods, as I said, when you will read the Write For Us page or contributor page, you can see they might have mentioned that contact person name and email address on that page. They may have said that you can contact us through contact form on the website. You can contact them via email. In case you are not able to get their email, you can reach out to you can reach out them via Twitter or LinkedIn, and there you can humbly ask them that I want to get in touch with you, something related to content, so could you please give me your email ID so we can probably talk further. Email is one of the most widely, most popular and effective method to reach someone. So here are the some of the pointers for you to remember when you are using this method. So try to find the right editor to send an email. Now when you are reaching these big publications, they may have different editor for each of their section. So let's say they will have a different editor for their fashion section, they may have different editor for their business or travel section. So you make sure you are finding the right person and you are sending an email to the right editor. Now always use their email. It is always better to use someone's email rather than just saying hi or hi there or something like that. The second thing is, use the right subject line. As I said you earlier, please try to care to go through the Write For Us page or contributor page. Most of the guidelines are mentioned there. In some of the cases they have already written that if you are approaching for the guest post, this is a headline you should use in your as your subject line. So
you can use that, or if nothing is provided, just be straight, like want to be a contributor or want to write for your blog rather than using some random clickbait type of headline, because it will ultimately damage you more rather than providing any good value. And when you are writing an email, just get to the point. Don't use flattery. Don't say something like, I just stumbled upon your blog and I was reading this or that, or this post is something I really liked. Until and unless you have something specific to say. Don't just use such sentences in your email. By doing this, you will probably save your and editor's time, and of course they value that. Introduce yourself and your business. Of course editor won't know from your email that this is the person, so you have to introduce yourself. Who are you? Why are you enough capable to contribute on their blog? What you have done, what your business is all about. But yes, just be specific. You don't need to write so much in this. Try to include everything in two or three lines. Now pitch your topics that meet their focus but they haven't covered in depth. I keep telling you that you should spend time on their blog. You should check for the topics they have already published. Like when you are writing on B2B lead generation, you just check which are the posts they have already published. Is there any topic which is left out, which probably not covered in depth, and you can which topic is already covered but you think you can still add some value in that. And I am sure if you will pitch any such kind of topic which that site has not yet published, they will be really very much interested to read it. And at last, ask for a reply, take their follow up. So here I am showing you an example, a pitch I sent for one of my client. Here you can see, hi Mike, I am using Mike. I checked that Mike is the editor of that blog. So I have used here his name. Of course, everybody likes when you are using that name, right? So here, if you can see, this is Fong Li. I am the founder of IC Cars, an award-winning smart car search engine. Try to, as I said, introduce yourself and try to be as much informative as well as try to make it compact. Don't just go and say I am doing this or that and so many things at once. Just give the information which is required. Here, so I am introducing the client in the third line. I am just saying that he has 15 years of experience. Just show your expertise, why you are good enough or why you are the best person to write on that particular topic. Now this all you have said, right, by yourself. Now show examples that you have already written this post. And so, of course, reaching out this big publications, you have to prove what you are saying, not by your words but by what you have done. So here I have given some of the best example of the post published by this client. Here you can see one post is appreciated and republished by FEDA, and then this third post is the most read post for that particular month for that particular website.
So of course this really helps the editor to make the decision. Then again, you already know, right, when you are outreaching them that that website is accepting content. So why go back and forth? Just give what they want. That is how you will save both of your time. So you can give them headline and the outlines as well. Let give them 2-3 options to select from, and then last you can just ask that you are really willing to work with them and you are really interested to take this further. I'm sure once you will do this and you will do in right manner, you will definitely get reply from them. So once you sent an email, the last thing you can do is follow up. Always follow up a couple of times. Of course, these editors are busy, so sometimes they miss out some emails. In that case, probably you can float those emails on top of their inbox, and you can be considered. And allow them some time to consider and reply. And of course, sometimes it happens that person may have read your email, but they are in some situation that they can't reply immediately. So, or sometimes some replies require more time than usual. So like they want some changes in your headlines, or they want your post to they want to write something different, they want you to write something that topic in some different way, then in that case it will take for them to reply. And of course they may have other emails to catch up as well. So give them some time. Don't just after ever you are sending an email today and the other day or the day after tomorrow you are just going and asking, hey, did you have a time to check my email? Of course they didn't have, and that's why they have not replied you. You can probably try different time of the days, as we are doing worldwide, like when I am in India and I am our approaching sites based in USA. So I can probably reply, I can follow up with them at my night time, which will be morning or afternoon for them. So you can try different timings when you can follow up with them. Try contacting them on social media. You can sometime we don't know what goes there, right? Sometime it happens that your email just strictly go to their spam folder. So in that case you can contact them on their social media channels. Here you can see this real time board. I was trying to figure out their email ID, but on their website I could only find their sales at the rate realtime.board.com ID, but that is not the best way to contact them. So I just reach out on that Twitter ID and asked, hey, I am interested to write for your blog, could you please put me in touch with the editor? And as they were interested, they helped me with the further process and they gave me this support ID. And of course by doing all this, just be thankful. Whatever they are doing for you, they are investing time on you. So be thankful and be respectful. Even though once your piece is published, you can share those pieces on your social media. You can ask your connection to promote those pieces. So it will be win-win situation for both of you. And please don't disappoint if you are not getting reply. It happens. sometimes probably when you are starting out, you are probably not experienced enough, or probably sometimes it happens what you are offering to the editor, they are not looking that particular thing at that time, and sometimes you won't receive reply at all from them. So probably after 2 and 3 follow-ups, you can give it some. And you can try after a few months, probably when you have gained more expertise on that particular subject. I was trying for ink almost 3 years. Yes, after 3 years, I got success and I was able to be a contributor over there. So yes, it happens. So you can of course give time to yourself as well as the editor. So now the thing is, people are always afraid and they think whether it would be a good idea to post your best piece of content on some other site. So let me clear your this doubt. They think that they have put so much effort, why they should waste it on some other site? But trust me, it is not wasted. It will be useful to you. Here is one example. This content marketing keyword, Marketing Insider Group, which is ranking on second number, is my client. Now, Michael Brenner, who is the owner of this blog, he was ranking earlier on the first position here for this particular search term. Now, then he did a post on Content Marketing Institute, that he was ranking for why you need a content marketing workshop. Then it was in July. This post was published in April. Then in July, we decided to do a post on Content Marketing Institute. Now, this Content Marketing Institute is such a popular website. It is in content marketing. They give certifications and they run courses. So, whenever any piece is published there, they immediately start getting tons of engagement, shares. So, of course, this website is having more authority than my client. So this post started ranking first. Now you can see here my client is ranking at 3 places. First 3 places are secured by Marketing Insider Group. And have you noticed one thing here? See, Michael is getting his intent very nicely. Here he is providing an answer, how to run a strategy focused content workshop. Here he has done a post, why you need. So he is solving all the problems of the users, what, why and how. Now when you will see this post on Content Marketing Institute, here you can see content marketing workshop. It is linking to his money page, his website page. So this, trust me, no other link can be best link than this for him. No other link, because this website is that good. So here Michael, through his thought leadership, he is helping this website as well as he is helping his website as well. And Michael is answering all the possible questions for his readers. So it doesn't matter that it won't happen in all the cases that those websites will link your pages, but even though it will be only beneficial to you here, if you will this definitely drives qualified traffic for Michael as much as his own website can drive. And as you
saw here, they are already top three. He is already ranking in top three. So this is also a post by him. This is also very good website, Content Marketing World. So why to miss a chance? See, if you can rank at three position, what could be better than this for you? So here what I want to convey is, when you it doesn't necessary that it is not necessary that you have to put best content on your website only. See, I myself is a contributor over more than 50 websites, but I don't have any, my best content is out there. Why? Because a dentist doesn't have to pull out her own tooth before she pulls out yours, does she? Once you have proven your expertise, once you have built your authority, built your reputation in your industry, you can easily stop chasing after clients. And you, instead, you can approach clients as if you are hiring them. Make them come to you. Like you are hiring people, where you post your job requirements on your website or other job portals, and people out there read those requirements and come to your company for the interview. The same way, you make your so good that you get the clients. And this is what I want to share with you by the way of this presentation, what can be called content marketing powerhouse. When you will be the content marketing powerhouse, the best brands will come to you with their requirement. How? Let's see. I am the fan of pyramids. This is the traditional way of marketing we all have taken till now. Like first you spread your brand awareness, and then you reach out to the widest audience in your market, and then you capture them in your lead generation or lead nurturing funnel. You get them fill out your contact forms or probably ebooks or through downloads. You get their contact details, and then you identify a few clients, and later on chase them with sales calls, emails, or probably personal visits. And this is how you make sell. This is what marketers have done till now. But again, I have this habit of turning the pyramids on their head, and this is the newest and most successful approach today. Why? Because this is the age of information. People out there know everything about, they are so much informed. They already know about market. They know the nature of the product and all sorts of purchasing and sales. This purchasing and sales are driven by consumers, not by the company that is selling it. And that's why we have seen the importance of account-based marketing here. What is account-based marketing is ABM is something that turns the traditional marketing funnel on its head. So instead of starting from brand awareness and moving down to lead generation and finally finding the clients for you, we start with identifying clients you want to work, and that works only you have shown your expertise. Like my team is good with creating content for SaaS, e-commerce, and tech startups. We love this type of contents. So if I say so for myself, we are very good at doing this.
So I can go out there and identifying clients which I am confident that my team will deliver the best to work. So say I am doing this for Semrush or Nutanix or probably Cisco or IBM, and these are couple of brands I can relate with. AHREF, who is again competitor of Semrush, I would identify how I will contact them. I would identify people in this company. I would engage with them through various social channels, and if needed, I will run personalized campaigns, and I will help them out for free if the requirement arises. So when we have once I have identified I want to work with this client, what I know is I am not going to quit until I land them. What I will do, I will go out and see what kind of problems they are facing, what kind of questions they are asking on social media. I will visit their website and what probably their job pages, what kind of jobs they are putting on their job page. I will try to find where they are lacking, what are the gaps in their growth which I can feel I can help them, how I can provide them solution, and how I can be helpful to them. So this is how I would want them to see and that is, once I will help them, or once I will be a person who is helping them in all these things, I would want them to see me as their go-to person for their digital marketing or content marketing initiative whichever running in their company. So even if they are currently not actively looking for that requirement, whenever in future that requirement arises, they will contact me. They will remember that yes, Dipti is one person who is in my network who can probably handle this in a better way, because she is already commenting on my post, or she has already helped us. So she is probably the person who can take this further easily. And once they are already in my communication or contact, it will be easy for them also to build this business relationship further. Trust me, this is the central core of my strategy that I want to share with you. This is something which will work for any client or any company. And again, this is something which can be scalable if you are doing it right. So this is one example of my client Michael Brenner, his testimonial. If you see this, let me read this out loud for you. I must say the results are surprisingly good. We have a 20% rise in web traffic in less than 4 months, with a big jump in domain authority to boost. And what's more important is Dipti made a real proactive effort to understand and improve my core business. So what we delivered is we delivered what he initially hired us for. But of course, we didn't stop there. We went one step ahead. Not in fact one step. We went miles ahead. We tried and provided him other solutions, whichever we could possibly deliver. So currently it is like he is also providing digital solutions which he was not providing earlier. So of course this is win-win situation for both your client and you. So this is the summary or whatever I was telling you in IBM till now. How you can target your clients and how you can identify and contact these prospects. See, here I don't have any preset that email format they can use, or we don't have any formula as well, because every formula is different for each client. Each client is going to be different. You, as I said, you have to study what your clients are looking for, as your clients would be different, their requirements would be different. You can identify company as I am saying, you have to identify companies first. You have to identify what are the mistakes they are making, if they have currently they are doing something, what kind of mistakes they are making, or what kind of where you can probably improve. You can provide your insights, and you can improve whatever you are doing, and then you can analyze their marketing and PR, what is their budget, and you can build relationship with the key persons of this companies who you think you can communicate with you and build relationship, and they can introduce you in their company. Here, see, this is my pro tip which I have learned through my experience, and you won't learn anywhere else. Do search if they check their current job openings. See what are the gaps they are finding, what are the capabilities they are looking for, and trust me, this will be really helpful. Now, see, if I am targeting, this is one page, I have blurred the client name. This is their job page. Here you will see they are looking for content crafter. To be strong candidate, you will have ability to do long tail keyword SEO research, which I can do. Ability to use content tools like SEMrush, content templates. I am very well aware of that. A basic understanding of Google Analytics data, I am very good at this again. Ability to cut straight to the point with writing, and that is my specialty. And solid understanding of SaaS buyer's journey. Now I know I have all this, right? I know I have all these capabilities. So yes, at one point let's see, if this is a test, I have cleared one part. Now they might have mentioned they are looking for individuals, not companies. But still, you can give it a try. Here you can see salary up to $25 an hour, and weekly time 20 hours a week. Now how much it would be, I can do the math that quickly. So let's say it is probably $2,000 a month, yes, $2,000 a month. But if you are good at this and you give it a try, you contact this person, and if you are delivering good result, I don't think anybody would be that stubborn, or that they would, once their requirements are being satisfied, they would really love to hire you or let go some of their things, because ultimately what they want to do is they want to get better results for their company, right? So even if their budget is, of course, budget is the most important thing, their budget is $2,000 or $3,000, and $3,000, and I am doing this $4,000, but if they are getting better quality in that, trust me, they would really, really choose you.
because they also trust agencies more than individual. So how you can do this is assume you are presenting your proposal in person, right? Whenever you are sending a proposal, you just assume you are sending this proposal in person. You think you are in the same room with the client and with probably a whiteboard. What mistakes will you point out? What new strategies or tactics or tips you will recommend them? You can probably reveal a secret or two, but of course don't reveal so much. And then how you are going to price for your service, when you are going for a job, how you are negotiating, so how you can negotiate with that person. Of course this is not something cloud calling or in video call. You will have limited time to explain the things, you will have limited time, or you won't be able to understand your client very well, though through social media or whichever efforts you have put till now. Try to understand their requirement and their nature of nature of requirement in better way, and prepare the proposal the same way. And of course be prepared for the rejection. In case they say no, don't get discouraged, don't lose your heart. You remember we inverted pyramid at the beginning. So yes, we have very narrow pool of client, probably 1, 2, 3 or a few. So of course but you, even though they say no, you don't stop helping them out. Be in their connection, keep your relationship going with them, because this will be helpful. Probably they might not have budget, and there might be various reasons. So in future it is possible when they will have budget, they will approach you. Or even though they will not approach you, I am sure they are the best person to recommend you. Trust me, this has happened with me. So they will recommend you, they can recommend good other clients to you. So keep that relationship going, because yes, relationship also works in business. Now when we have already gone through all the steps of content marketing, what comes next is, how do you know whether whatever you have done is right or not, or whether you are on the right path or not? So content marketing is not any app or a software or a product, so you will have an exact ROI that this many downloads has been done. So yes, you are doing good job, but still there are some things, some KPIs you can look, like traffic, engagement and mini conversions, and decide that whatever you are doing is good enough. So let's say traffic, how much traffic your each post is bringing, from which sources, what are the channels, are your prospects reading your whole post, how much time they are spending, what are the unique page views. which pages they are going to, and many conversions. You can select your contact form, whether they are filling up your forms or downloading any ebook, or whether they are signing up for your emails, they are purchasing your newsletter. So that all can be considered your mini conversions. The second thing is follow your content calendar. As I am saying this since beginning of the presentation, that content marketing is a long game. It is not something you can do for a month or two. How will you stick to it? You know what, all the top publications have an editorial calendar where they set the themes for the whole year, the themes for each month, like February, for January, February and March, and throughout the whole year for the each month they have different themes. That way it makes easy for them. So the same way you can also decide themes and the topics, probably headlines at the beginning of your campaign. And if not for the whole year, you can at least create it for minimum 6 months, and you have to stick to it, and then only you will get any result. So yes, of course, when it is possible, then that some event comes up, or that like this COVID time, that type of some time comes, so you can of course make some amendments in that, but try to be on time, or try to stick it as much as you can do it. And the third thing is always keep doing SEO. How do you improve? After writing all this post, what you can do? Another thing is SEO. Content and SEO always go hand in hand. If you will check your traffic sources, if you will check your Google Analytics, organic search will always be the top source of traffic for any site, because search engine will help you meet all goals of content marketing. Here you will see organic search, you have got maximum visit, then there are some visits from direct, referral, social, email. If you are doing PPC, then you can see, suppose it is possible PPC can PPC might be bringing you more traffic, but it is only when you are paying for it. Once you will stop paying from today, you will start seeing results from tomorrow. So organic is the always the best way for you to get traffic for the longer period of time. And always keep trying for the featured snippet, because featured snippet brings you more clicks. Here you can see people have different opinion for this, like some people says if you are in featured snippets you won't get more visits, but trust me, it is not like this. When you are in featured snippet, here is one article, the top 11 most effective B2B marketing strategies for 2020. Here you can see 7 strategies, and if you are really interested to read this blog, of course you are going to go on that particular blog to see those rest of the 4 activities. So yes, to be there in feature snippet is the should be your goal for each post, I suggest. And finally, remember that mastery takes time. In content marketing, patience is the name of the game. because we are constantly chasing different people like writers, editors, and our clients, of course. So lot of the things depend on them. In fact, most of the things depends on them. So it is really, really easy for us to lose our courage at some point. But and that's why at the beginning of this campaign we set content calendar, because marketing can't be done in 30 days. You need at least a year for mastery. You can see here someone has tried to write a book on how to do marketing in 30 days. Let's see how many reviews it has got. Nobody, right? There is no any review here. Because what I have walked you through here is agency level stuff. It's almost beyond the reach of even highly motivated individual. So every successful blogger or company blog manager will tell you that they spent at least 2 years killing flies before they started testing success. It really takes years to achieve mastery, but of course with a proper plan everyone will eventually get there. That's it from me. Thanks for watching my presentation. If you have any queries, doubts, or any questions, please feel free to reach out to me. My ID is hi@deeptiparmar.com. deeptiparmar.com is my website. If you have any doubt or any specific queries regarding content marketing or reaching out to the editors, I would be more than happy to help you. Here are my social channels. I am most active on Twitter and LinkedIn. I would be glad to connect with all of you over there. Thanks again, Mats, for having me here. I can't say how grateful I am. I would be really glad if I can help you with creating your content strategies or getting more clients for you. So yes, thank you so much.